It's full. Doesn't feel like it.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, start over.
It's fall. Take two.
Hey, guys.
Hey, guys, it's the V-Cube Solver here.
Yeah, we're going to... Okay, start over. You gotta let me know when you're recording. I thought you were taking like a pano shot.
It's hot as heck out here, man. Look, the leaves are all dry and it's like a desert. I mean, in the mornings there's just this big yellow haze.
You say, but it's fall technically, right?
Well, you know, it's definitely a little cooler, I think. And the light just looks more golden, like fall.
Well, yeah, we're in the shade. It's not so bad where we are. Where are we, actually?
We're at Maxwell Creek Park.
Yeah. Kind of a cool little spot that we discovered with some neat woodsy trails behind here, right?
Oh, yeah.
And like a little nature preserve of some kind, apparently, too, that the town keeps up. And there's also a historical cemetery back here. Oh, who's coming? Who's this? Uh-oh, it's the pony owner.
What do you mean, uh-oh?
And
Anthony!
Boo! Boo! What do we got? What's this? What's that?
We got some Sprecher's root beer.
Wow. What's famous about Sprecher's?
It's the best root beer in the universe.
Who says?
Who said that? I think it was Brian?
It's multi.
From Review the World?
Brian Hammonds of ReviewTheWorld.com says this is just about as good as you're ever going to get for a root beer, and we're about to give it a shot.
Come on, buddy.
So, what's your opinion on root beer in general?
I love root beer. I always have. My grandmother used to make it out of this weird mix, and she'd mix it up in like a gallon jug. And I didn't really like that all that much growing up, but the carbonated beverages and stuff I did. I'm a big fan of Mug. You get that a lot at fast food restaurants and stuff like that. And I think that, I'm trying to remember, Barks is the one out of Louisiana. I like Barks. I like Mug root beer. I love IBC, which is a Dallas-based beer. And I really, really sold Brian on Virgil's root beer, because that's something that they have at Whole Foods, and it's this organic root beer that they make from fresh ingredients and all that kind of stuff, and it is very good. You've had it, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's won awards and all that, but he says that, you know, nothing really can hold a candle to Sprecher's. Now, I've never seen this in a store until I found this little place called Rocket Fizz in Deep Ellum in Dallas, and it just opened up a week or two ago. And so finally, I've been dying to give this a shot. Here it is.
I can't wait.
Now, he says this has like a real creamy, well, it has a lot of fizz on it.
Hmm.
You know, nice head, so I'm going to give it a shot, see what it's like. Yeah, this is really good. This is it's like a mix of a lot of the different nice tastes of root beers that I love. The A&W, Barks, Virgil's. It does have the same sort of like clean taste that Virgil's has. I really like it. I mean, if you're in the mood for root beer, this is
your favorite?
I think so.
Whoa.
What's up? Hey, come over here. You're just in time. Why don't you try this out? Come over here. Stand right here.
What's that?
Root beer. You want to try it?
You have to come see this, Dad.
What? You don't like it? Why?
Dad, you have to come
this
see
is this. Like the best root beer. And he's stamping on it, and he's poking a stick into the ground where he spit it out. That's how much he hates it.
Why? Well, baby Anthony doesn't like root beer, apparently.
I'm going, Dad.
Don't even ask me.
Lucy?
No!
What? You don't like it?
Ew.
Okay. Not some big root beer fans here.
Wow.
Let's have you try it.
All right.
Okay, after that little episode, I think we'll recover. Okay, so, like, what's your anticipation for this, huh?
I think it's going to be up to par with Virgil, which is...
Now, I wish I had had Virgil's more recently to give a true comparison, but I'm going to say that this is... There's nothing lacking at all in the taste, flavor. Go ahead, give it a shot.
I like it.
To be honest, I mean, I find there's nothing that, like, it's not like I'm blown away, but I can see why people would say that this is the best ever. I mean, every good quality I can think about all the different root beers I've had, this, you know, this has it.
All the flavors seem to pop. It's not just one mess.
Yeah.
It's,
and I love the creaminess of it, which you don't get in every root beer. But at the same time, it's not like cream soda creamy, you know? It's just smooth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like it. It's nothing like, whoa, this is amazing.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I really like it. I would recommend it. The bottle, mm-hmm. It's very big, so.
Yeah, it's nice and fat. You do get a lot in there. Sprekers, a success?
Yeah. I'm not sure if it's my favorite, but I really do like it.
Signing off. The buddy team. We still buddies?
Yeah. Nice.
Addendum, because I just noticed something.
Yeah?
It says that this... Oh, I'm looking at the wrong label. Yeah. This truly old-fashioned soda has the rich, creamy flavor that only comes from using Wisconsin honey direct from the combs, man. They use honey in here. I like that.
Yeah.
Can you taste the honey?
Oh, yeah.
One more time. Honey riff.
Mm-hmm. It's funny because after you mentioned...
Yes, you were saying?
It's funny because after you mentioned that it's made with honey, I really noticed it in there.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
I agree.
Cut.